you have somebody here who has hurt you, you hate that person. That person dominates your thoughts. You are all the time thinking of that person only, not the person whom you love. So, forgive or put delete button, remove him from your life, but don't be angry and wishing bad things for them. So, desire to continue learning and self-improvement. See, knowledge is improving. Earlier, every 1,000 years the knowledge doubled. Then every 100 years, every 10 years. Now, every day knowledge is doubling. That's why the professors are very reluctant. The Vice Chancellor was telling me how people are reluctant to come to teaching jobs. Because today, thanks to Uncle Google, very often the students come prepared more than the professor. So the teacher, those days are gone, what I have learned in my doctorate can keep on. I have to learn every day to be up to date, to deal with students, you know. So it's self-improvement. See, for example, today, the IPS officers are taught everything on the digital, everything. Those days, you know, not knowing ABCD. Today, these youngsters are so masters, you know, they're able to do it. But the criminals are always one step ahead of us. You know, this cyber crime and all that, the whole world is struggling to deal with them. So, honesty, I told you, vision, innovation, capacity, willingness to grow or change, ability to function as a team builder, nothing can be done alone. Only a team can for ethical and inspiring leadership. So, this is very important. Ethical goals are good, ethical leaders, all these things. Now, just for quality of certain leadership, Bhagavad Gita says, you all know that, whatever action is, a great man performs, common man follows. And whatever standards he sets, for example, he acts, all the world sees. So, how the leader is, that's how the followers also will be there. The manager administers, as I told you, the leader innovates. A good leader commands the highest respect because he is trustworthy, dependable, and gives strength and courage to those around him. A leader must have the right balance and combination of vision, values, competence, courage, and character, willing to sacrifice his own position to protect the people who have worked with him and all that. So, why the leaders are respected? Because they always do the right thing. And a leader is the organization's greatest asset. The history of the world is full of men who rose to leadership by sheer force of self-confidence, bravery, and tenacity. By these methods, we will learn values and wisdom. First, by reflection, which is noblest. On your own, if you can do it. Second, by imitation, following others. And third, by experience, that is the harshest. We suffer. We tell the child, don't touch the flame. The child accepts, fine. Otherwise, he says, no, you'll touch the flame, burn it, and then learn also. So, better to. Creative leaders are those whose leadership styles move from commander to coach. So, patriotism is again supporting your country. This is Mark Twain said. Patriotism is supporting your country all the time and the government only when it deserves it. Transparency is very, very important. Humility is the greatest quality, I told you. Now, great leader is one, to sum up, who never wastes his time, he is never short of time for the good he can do. Don't say you don't have enough time. You have exactly the same number of hours per day that were given to Helen Keller, Pasteur, Michelangelo, Mother Teresa, Leonardo da Vinci, Thomas Jefferson, Albert Einstein, Mahatma Gandhi, and if you want to see a comparatively, you can say Mr. Narendra Modi and many other leaders of his circle. Okay, now business values. Business values, I'm going to sum up in just another 5 minutes time. It is not only making profit, include other forms of value, such as employee value, customer value, supplier value, channel partner value, alliance partner value, management value, and society value. That's why CSR and others has come into the business value was, for example, one or more business values was the key to their success. For example, there are many, but I'm telling you, are non-controversial, Tata's. 70% of the profit goes to Tata charity. They retire at the age of 75, including Ratan Tata retired. They have a policy not to give bribe for anything. Otherwise, they would have stopped their airline long back if they had given the bribe to the minister who demanded it. They would have done it. And Warren Buffett, the richest man in the world. Who is the other man? Who is the richest? Bill Gates. One of them becomes the richest each year. 90% of their wealth goes to charity. Not only to Americans or Christians, it goes to all over the world. Wherever people are suffering from poverty, illiteracy, ill health, they go. Somebody asks Warren Buffett, now tell me, 90% of your wealth goes outside. Hardly 10% goes to your family. Why do you want to keep on investing and making more money? He said, I enjoy making money, but much more enjoyment I give than I give to people who deserve it, who needs it. See the heart. Same with Bill Gates also, many of them trying to do in India also. I don't say that we are not doing it now. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you something. Without values, we would be mechanical like beings, driven here and there by the vicissitudes of life. Without values, we would be creature-like, compelled to act solely by our urges and passions. In this inhuman existence, there would be little consideration for truths we hold dear, let alone implement them to enable and enrich our lives. In this reality devoid of values, we would be live unconscious lives without meaning or purpose. On the other hand, when we take to values, we live a purposeful and dynamic existence to become truly human. Forget becoming divine. This being the case, what are the truths of life? If we think about it, we will see that people relate to personal values in a number of ways. Thoughtful people are continuously thinking about those things that cherish and believe in. Powerful people are also motivated and driven to implement them in their lives. In fact, the most successful people are constantly evaluating their values and are continually driven to turn them into a living reality. For these individuals, values are an inexhaustible source of inner power that energizes them to no end, luring them into the heights of success while bringing about deep fulfillment in their lives. A combination of values applied to a situation dramatically energizes circumstances, which not only increases the likelihood of success, but turns the interaction into an enjoyable, even thrilling experience. Thus, we all have values that determine that decisions and guide our lives. Those who value their individuality take responsibility and self-reliant and act with self-respect. So a complete mentioned life depends not only on physical energy, but even more so on the intensity of psychological energy we are able to impart to bring in our action. So gentlemen, we can go on and on, but I wrote up a newsletter recently on the, every month I go to 4 or 6 major events, and when I'm impressed by something that's happening and my heart is touched, then I devote it once a month, do some research also, because what they do should go to the world. For example, ISRO, they invited me for Dr. Abdul Kalam Memorial Lecture. They requested me, please stay with us. ISRO, you know, the people who launch these satellites. They said, please stay with us for 2 days. I stayed with them on the campus. Amazing. Though I lived in Bangalore for a long time, we all know our satellite launching capacity is as good as the best in the world. I was amazed at the the dedication of the people, from the smallest to the topmost character. So, I didn't take down notes. My memory is not good. But still, that month was a busy month. I was studying every day. At the end of the month, I said, people should know what makes them what they do. Their dedication. So I wrote about a newsletter on that. And then about 8-9 pages, the photograph they sent, did some research on the Google. I wrote a letter which now goes to about 100,000 people around the world, whoever has given the email to me. The director, Mr. Kiran Kumar, told me, this is the best assessment, honest assessment of ISRO by a non-spaceman. So I am sending copies to 17,000 of my employees alone. So a lot of appreciation from all over the world came. Same about Bombay Airport, I hope. People said, we did not know India is capable of producing such thing. Now the reason one is, you know, Akshay Patra, you have heard of that. Akshay Patra, you know, ISKCON people. They have been inviting me for a long time. So recently I went and they booked me a hotel. I said, no, I won't stay in the campus, I'll stay in the temple. For 3 days I spent with them, amazing people. They are known only for Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. But the other aspect which touched me was their founder. Their founder, one day when he was chanting in somewhere in Calcutta only, he found a lot of noise around. Opened the windows and saw the poor children fighting for food along with the street dogs. They throw away leaves, no? So he said, no, our task is to feed people. So these people, two monks actually, one is an IIT graduate, held a high position. Another is an Indian Institute of Science graduate, high position. Became devotees of Krishna, his own part of it, it's okay. Now, in the year 2000, they started feeding 1,500 children, government school children. Because government school people go, only poor people go, or government class. These days a lot of private schools have come. Only who are not comfortable, you know. They said they must get at least one healthy, nutritive, hot meal a day. So they selected some schools. They sent food for 1,500 children. Hot, nutritive food supplied in the school during the lunch break. That is about 17 years back. Today, can you believe what they are doing? They are serving hot, nutritive meals in the school premises for 17 lakh children. See, that means, you know, many of us are not aware of it. 17 lakh children. Hot meals. There are so many central kitchens. All two monks. They have the religious practice, building temples, that's good. But they said one of the compassion you value is feed the poor. 17 lakh children, of course, half the money comes from the government, half the money comes from the corporates like Infosys, Tata and all that. But, you know, the cost of the food, the meal, I have tested it also. Hot, nutritive meal in the school premises, served most hygienically, prepared and served, 12 rupees. You want to get a cup of tea today. Because it's so honestly spent. All dedicated people. They found many more people coming and joining. And doing it, 12 rupees, out of which 6 rupees come from the state and central government, 6 rupees they get donations from corporates and private individuals and all that. Now seeing this, the largest noon meal scheme in the world, that's what I wrote my newsletter, it has gone. Seeing this functioning, there are demands from other countries. You know, UK is not a poor country. They serve 2000 noon meals, London School of Economics, and outside, they joining with somebody else, they are giving 2,000 meals, noon meals, more and more people going to do it. Because they are, if the people know, they are willing to do it honestly, they are willing to donate also. So, these are all these ones. Now, after seeing my letter, many more have contributed, and somebody from Calcutta said, we will give land in Haryana, will they do it? Somebody said, you know, in all and Institute of Medical Sciences, today morning I got a message. There are a lot of poor patients, you know. Poor patients are there. People who come with them all over the country, they are all sleeping on the street also. Can you do something about it? See, this is still only 25% of the children are malnourished in our country. I am sure there are lakhs of children, people go with only 1 meal a day or even a day. So these are all values. Each one of us can do it. Now one journalist, see Jyoti Malhotra, she met me in the Chinese embassy function yesterday. He said, Mr. Karthikeyan, I saw your letter. I am not rich person, I am sending 10,000 rupees to them. So Dasa has written, every rupee comes to me. Don't feel shy you are giving 10,000 rupees. Of course it goes to 100 crores. Every rupee helps. Every rupee helps like that, you know. So why I am sharing this is to say, we are not helpless. You can't think what can I do. Everyone can. In management schools particularly, when I go for qualifications, first I talk about the fitness. Then I say, how many children are lucky like you to come to prestigious institutions? Like Christ College University, when I spoke the other day convocation, I said, how many? Hardly 10% of those who want to go for higher education get this opportunity. Now all of you get a degree and also get a job on hand. I said, make one commitment. That suppose not more than 50% in this country are below poverty line. And certainly 50% are above poverty line. They say only 30% are below poverty line. Even granting 30% are below poverty line, if each one of us above poverty line can take care of 1% below poverty line, there is no poverty in this country. You can do it because you're all, you can't do much, but at least you can do that. Take a bow and do it. Try, find out somebody closer to you who is not in well-to-do. Take care of education, feed and all that, do it. So, ladies and gentlemen, I do want to keep on going now. And all of, there's all nothing new to you, all are known. But I only say that each of us has a capacity to do something. None of us are so helpless. Each one of us are empowered. You are all fortunate people in this world. One third of the world is still in poverty. They can all make a contribution. First duty is be healthy. Unless you are healthy, you become a liability. And you, the health is in your hands. Doing the right things, right thoughts, right activities, right food, right time, watching the right movies only. Going to the right movies, that beautiful channel, that 300-400 channels, some of the channels are so beautiful. I can spend 24 hours there, so many channels are there. They give positivity, you know, give hope to us. They give a lot of ideas to say that each one of us are capable of doing wonders. Even if we take care of ourselves, a family, one more person, we have done a great service to. As they say again and again, what is it you can do to your creator, God? You lead a happy, healthy life, it's a gift to God. Lead a happy, healthy life, you have to take care of somebody else also. Even it's so. Thank you very much. If you have any questions to ask, I am willing to share my thoughts with you. If you have the time, I don't mind. Yes.
I like to ask.
Come forward, sir. Oh, you got a mic here. No, no, be there. Mike is coming to you. Mike is coming to you.
Please hand out this letter to the... Vishwanathan Mudaliya.
Long letter, ma'am. This is for police officers.
Also, they found that it has come from Uttar Pradesh. It has come from Uttar Pradesh.
They will do it, yes. Kindly.
Yes, yes.
Please do it here.
Yes.
And give a response to him.
Yes.
If something which had to have been done, do it.
Yes.
Or you simply have to tell him why you cannot do it. Yeah.
I am Vishwanath Mudaliya from Saraswati Vidyalaya. I am positive. Then I did diploma.
No, no. You be a brief question.
Yes.
Don't
so
tell your life story.
These type of things are going on.
Yes.
Online frauds as well as what we call in Google, which is all misused.
Yes.
And this type of crimes, putting all senior persons and others and small children in the name of 10 or 12 years, they are all doing, but they are sent to these homes.
Thank you.
Yes.
We'll do it. It'll be done. Anybody else? Anything else? Yes, yes. It's working. Keep it close to your mouth.
In the Rajiv Gandhi assassination case, so लोगों को सर अभी तक की death की punishment क्यों नहीं दी?
Oh, death punishment.
Sir, I want to ask first.
I think it's not working, ma'am.
Before answering this question, if you could go into some part of the very famous case that you have handled, then you would love to.
Yes, I will tell you. It can normally in an academy, police academy, I take 4 words to talk about it. But in four lines like a sutra. Yes, he was killed by a human bomb when he was addressing the election meeting at Sriperumbudur on 21st May 1991 at 10:20 p.m. She pretended to be his admirer, offered the garland, went down and pressed the switch of the bomb, suicide bomb. It exploded. Of course, like this, because she was bent and he was also looking, the front portion of the body of Rajiv Gandhi was completely blown off. There was no face, there was no chest. Her body is concerned, the head was on place, 2 legs on place, 1 hand which pressed apart, completely torn into pieces. It was blind. It was a very tough case. It was presumed to be a remain a mystery, as I mentioned to you, forever. But then, with a lot of hard work, sacrifice, and keeping it apolitical, never allowed any interference, we succeeded in finding out who they are. And Interpol, International Police Organization, which is in France, they had an international board meeting. They called me to address. They called it the first ever investigation successfully done of assassination of a world-class leader by a human bomb. Then you know we are charged with them, it went on and on. It was proved the Supreme Court, 3 judges of the Supreme Court upheld the investigation, recorded appreciation on the investigation, they praised me also. That is the story, you know, it's a 27-year-old now. A book is there, it has come in Marathi also. Not everything, but the book we wrote, I didn't want to write, but then judges of the Supreme Court asked me, please write. People should know what happened actually, otherwise all stories will come. So he wrote 1,000 pages, it came. But nobody will read 1,000 pages, so I had to delete so much. I gave a copy to Mrinalini, both Marathi and English versions. I brought one own copy, the only person I knew before I came. So I sent it to her. It is there on Amazon. Flipkart and all. It was out of print for the 7th edition now. It has come into all languages. Marathi edition, I'm told, is good. It was done by. Anything else? What is sentence? Death sentence. Death sentence, you know, it is. See, the law, Tada says death sentence. Trial court said all of them are involved under the Tada Act because conspiracy. The person who killed Rajiv Gandhi died on the spot. The law says whoever is taken a part in that conspiracy, played any role, they are equally guilty, as if they have killed. So they are all sentenced to death by the trial court. But Supreme Court took a different view. They said Tada will not apply because it is not an act of terrorism, which I disagree. If killing of the former Prime Minister in an election meeting by a foreign terrorist group, for what he did as Prime Minister for the interest of India, and because of which the whole country's history changed, elections are postponed, is not a terrorist act. What is this going to be a terrorist act? But whatever it is, that Supreme Court petition, I am disagreed with that. Then we went in again review. Normally Supreme Court doesn't say that we had done a wrong thing. So it's there, it's all right. And then there were 7 of them were sentenced today. Because of that interpretation, only one perspective. Others have already given a sentence of 10 years for other offences, not for act of terrorism. So 7 out of 7, 4 were sentenced to death, 3 life imprisonment. And you know the story what happened, you know. And now all the 7 are undergoing death imprisonment. They keep appealing that they should be released because they have been in prison for nearly 26 years. But that's for the government to take it.
I have a question on your very significant lecture on values. We find values are very important in our life, but what are the factors responsible for its deterioration right now, particularly with the younger generation?
No, and values are my younger generation. They follow what the other generation. They see what is happening. Well, what type of leadership we have, by and large, barring exceptions. People do not have faith. They feel all political parties, they don't have faith. That's the problem. We don't have a leader like Mahatma Gandhi or even Dr. Abdul Kalam. There may be some individuals where they are not in public view. So this is unfortunate. Not all are corrupt. There are many who are, many politicians are honest, dedicated, many officers, many judges are all honest. But then the public perception is, they don't trust anybody. They think people in power cannot do right thing. People in authority, unfortunately, there is a very wrong perception. So we have to educate the people. There must be some examples. So it's a change has to come from all over. I told you moral values first. I come from village school, not much of education, but then these moral values were there. They must be brought back. See, you must differentiate religious education from spiritual education. I would say even religious education is necessary. You know, I have been to a longer answer for you because they asked me, you have been to 150 countries. Yes. Suppose we have, they ask questions, you know, students ask. We have time, money, opportunity to go to only three countries. Where should we go? Which I say normally, promptly I said, Kailas Mansarovar, Jerusalem, Cambodia. They say, why? See, Kailas Mansarovar is considered holiest by three major religions. People believe in religions. Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, even Sikhism. 20,000 feet above sea level. Faith for thousands of years. I will not go into whether right or wrong. Jerusalem, because more than 70% of the population of the world consider that to be the holiest place. Christianity, Judaism and Islam also. And the new religion Baha'i, also on the Mediterranean. So the 95% may be non-believers. So 90% of the world believes in something sacred. There must be something in that. I go there. I have gone there twice to Kailas Mansarovar, three times to Jerusalem. I have been to Bethlehem, which is on the other side, where Christ was born. I have been to meditate Baha'i, you know, Haifa and Dako, where Baha'i religion was born. I go all these places. Wherever I go, I ask them, the local people, which is considered the most sacred place, take me there. It can be a mosque, it can be a... I've been to Assisi three times, six times to Vatican. I've been to Karachi, I don't know, Lahore. They took me to the most important mosque there. I go everywhere, I feel that it's meaningless to fight on religion and all that. You are born in a religion, be true to your religion, it's fine. Because all your ancestors have done it, you don't have to disown it. But all religions say the same values. Universally accepted, even God, you say, Vice Chancellor? Compassion, kindness, caring, sharing, respecting each other. No. Be true to your own religion. I think the Queen of Spain, a devotee of the Shankaracharya of Kanchi, the elder person, Paramacharya, she asked him, my lady, should I change it? He said, no. No need. Be a Christian, be a true Christian. He said that. There's no need, you know, at all. But respect. Why I say religion education is important? Because lack of education, people misunderstand religions. If you teach the values of all religions in all institutions, people will know there is nothing wrong with any religion. So what is meaning spiritual education? Spiritual, that is universally accepted common values, common to all humanity. There is no difference. Cultural values will change from time to time. As I told you, at one point of time, a woman can marry four or five husbands and a man can marry any number of lady girls. That was a culture, respected. It was all right at that time. Today, no. Today, man and woman are equal. In fact, more importance is given to the women. It will happen all over the world. This is the culture of the, you have to respect this. But universally accept human values don't change. Individual values don't change. Yes, sir.
Sir, Rishi sir, we all know that police forces overstretched all the time.
Keep it closer.
Yeah. So when can we expect some reforms that make their life easier?
Police reforms, you see, I'm not going to be pessimistic. I can say one word telling you deserve the, you get the government you deserve, you get the police you deserve. I won't say that. I'm not going to say that. Policemen are coming from the same society. So the societal values also have to go on. Police have a more responsibility. I have gone on record telling, if others commit a wrong, it is proved. If the sentence is on, we are, if the people in uniform or authority officers commit, it should be punished with 2 years. Because people have a lot of trust and power given to them. Police reforms have to start basically with political reforms. Politicization is responsible. So from my time to my this time, will you believe, when I was, the chief minister will come to a district. At the end of the tour, he will hand over a set of papers to me. Mr. Karthikeyan, these are representations. Go through, do what is right. You don't have to report to me. Transfers, postings, nothing. Then I had gone through it. Nobody, because they have so much of trust in us. And then the subordinates also look to the leader. Their future depended on him, not in the hand of an MLA or a minister. Today these things have changed in most of the states. Politicians interfere. So there is no discipline, no loyalty. I'm not taking generally some place, many places. So that is why the Supreme Court also tried to do some depoliticization. Something has been done, but a lot remains to be done. Unless you allow the police to function independently, they become answerable only to the law. And give the powers to the authority, the AG or Commissioner of Police or Sumna Police, and hold that man accountable. Today they will say, what can you do? That man, sub-inspector or inspector is not good, but then the minister has posted him. Once the minister posted him, his loyalty to the minister. So they very often make it complaints. First information reports are not registered, they are bound to register. They wait for instructions. These are all wrong things. In the long run, the society will lose faith in the whole system. Violence will breed. There will be civil strife. So before that, some reform has to happen. Public should demand it. Media should demand it. Things are not bad. Some places things are good, getting better, depending upon the ultimately the leader. Even today, in the whole conditions, the chief minister, for example, is a strong man. He wants to bring in good governance. He can discipline his ministers and MLAs. Don't interfere, allow the police to do the job. Then hold him accountable. Yes.
Sir, according to you, how you can see the scenario of investigation agencies or their changing roles nowadays, and what are the challenges they are facing now?
One is, I told you already, independence, power of independence. And the strength, the police strength is so low in our country. Compared to the other countries, the ratio of policemen to the population is so low. Not at all debate. You have to at least double the strength, minimum double the strength. And even the sanctioned posts are not filled up. Including Bombay City, for example, I know very well. I interact with the commissioner and others. Many places, police strength has been given and better recruitment. Recruitment also has to be very correctly done. Not on interference and all that. Only those who are fit, physically fit, and moral character has to be tested. Attitude. Are they good for the attitude of policemen? You have to be tolerant, you know. You have to put up with a lot of abuse and suffering. But you can't react like what you and I can relax on. Well, for that matter, attitude, their moral strength, physical strength is of course most important. Then the training. Training institutions should be given to very competent officers After that, service training every 5 years, postings to be done, and then the old accountable also be done. And then another thing, now for example, CBA, normally the question is CBA, they ask me, CBA was created only for certain very serious fraud anti-corruption cases. In fact, when I took up Rajiv Gandhi Station, it's a very rare case, a murder case being given. Today, the CBI norm is one investigating officer can investigate two cases in a year around that time. But today, because the people go to the courts telling we don't have faith in the local police, and then the high courts pass order, okay, CBI to take over the case. And they don't state government right to the government of India or go to Supreme Court. And very often these cases are handed over after years of the delay. Nothing can be done there. So too many cases given to, suppose a man can carry only 10 kilos on his head. You put 100 kilos, what will happen? So the investigation get delayed, quality of the investigation get deteriorated, and investigation takes long time. Then they file the charge sheet. By the time the case comes, in courts take much more time. Delay in courts is scandalous actually. And by the time the case is over, the investigation officer is dead, or the witnesses are dead, or the witnesses are bought over or threatened. So it's simple. So there is no punishment. So there is no fear of law. And particularly with people with money and resources, muscle power, see, they think they can get over it. So this is a very serious situation today. If people lose faith in the administration of criminal justice system, you can see what will happen. People take the law into their own hands. They settle scores. Let's say the gang warfare killing each other.
So one last question from my side. Sir, since you are the director.
Hello. Yes, I am hearing you.
Yeah. Director General of the Human Rights Commission of India. So what are some of the internal and the external threats that India faces that we don't know of?
The National Human Rights Commission deals with only complaints from victims, or so-called victims, to say we were ill-treated by this police officer, or they did not investigate the case, or even others, not only police, revenue authorities, wherever they feel the injustice is done to them by any person holding authority, any governmental, they won't complain. And then not all cases are taken up, because there are thousands and thousands of cases again. So some select cases are taken up, then commission issues notices to the concerned commissioner of police or superintendent of police or deputy commissioner or chief secretary, home secretary. This is the complaint what you say, they say they reply. If they give satisfactory reply, then they are dropped. If they don't give, if their commission is convinced, then ask them to pay a penalty to compensation to concern, or there is an investigation wing, ask the investigation wing of the commissioner to go and investigate personally, and they give a report. If the report is that no, the police or concerned officer has not done justice, then they are called, or sometimes they ask them to register the case against them or go to the court. Sometimes compensation is given, 8 lakhs, 10 lakhs and all that, apply with that. But then, not very effective, because the problem is so deep. And they are overwhelmed by lakhs of complaints. Only few cases are able to take it up. But it has some impact. Not as expected when it was created. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I would like to thank our team for this knowledge series session. Very first, I cannot forget to thank Dr. Rajan Velukar, Vice Chancellor, G.H. Raisan University. He is the supporting pillar for us, and he takes care about whatever the guidance we must have. And accordingly, sir is there always with us for the each and every area of whatever we arrange. Now in G.H. Raisan University in Sai Kheda, Chhindwara district, we are coming up with various courses With engineering and agriculture, we are coming up with the courses of law, pharmaceuticals, and other new courses for which you can visit ghru.edu.in. Accordingly, we have conducted the session with ICARA, which is the eminent body for agriculture, and we are having a team of ICAR with us for our agriculture university there in Saikhera. Secondly, I would like to thank Maaz Khan. He was there. He is a student of G.H. Raisoni CCST, Commerce College of G.H. Raisoni. And he is there with us and he is taking care about all the escorting and being with sir and is coordinating with us. Would like to thank Shriya. You know her skills now. Before me, she was here in front of the podium and she is a very good writer also. She has started writing for her blog. Maaz and Shriya, they both are taking care about the REAP program with Raisoni. REAP program is Raisoni Employability Advancement Program. The students were the students of first batch of this REAP program, and now they are taking care about that program, which has been organized for the students, in which we give the different skills to the students. That is again free of cost. I cannot forget to thank Amit Dandhare sir. He is PRO of Raisoni Group of Institutions, and for each and every program he is with us. So I can thank the media also. In his coordination we get the media people here always. Thank you so much media. And a huge thanks to Sunil Raisoni sir that he is there to organize all these sessions for us and for the foundation of this SGR Knowledge Foundation. Thank you all the audiences that you people are here always in all the sessions, and would like to announce the next program after I thank Dr. Karthikeyan for this informative session. Thank you so much sir, thank you so much that we are unable to get such details from the experts like you. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation. Next week we are going to organize this knowledge series session on 28th of July. And Dr. Devdutt Patnaik will be here for the session. So we'd like to invite you all, and it will be on the basis of registrations through SMSs and first come first serve basis. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here. Good night.